our collection set up at the stud in Wisconsin. So just at the end of two rows here, we have two collection pens. One at the end of each row. They are 4 feet wide by 8 feet long. And over here, by each collection pen, we have a walkway in between the collection pens and the warm-up pens. So there are two warm-up pens here that we can feed into the collection pens. So we can open this gate in the corner, let out into this alley, go in into the pen from this side, and mount the dummy. And then this center gate also swings to allow the board from this side over to here to go out into the alley and enter the collection pen. This is the back alley. So both of these gates, the gate from each collection pen, only swings one way into that back alley to let the boards go back. These are kind of spring-loaded here, the latches. Spring-loaded with a bungee cord, I guess. There's a handle down in the collection pen. So you can just pull it from the collection pen and stick the gate up. And this would be the warm-up pens. Two warm-up pens here. This one. And a similar setup over here on the other side as well. Just these have no pit. Here we have it. The fence. The walkthrough. Easy to get in there. We have the open space on the side that we're collecting in each room. Similar setup. I guess this is how you have it with no pit. You stand out here in this alley and you collect the floor level. There are primary pens here. We've got the collection pit. This is what the dummy looks like that we manufactured at Continental, which they are no longer manufacturing, so we're sourcing something similar from Canada. And I can show you what the underside looks like for the auto collect. Okay. That's the auto collect thing underneath. So we need to put the rail on the Canadian dummy to hold the auto collect. Anyway, don't know if this video is helpful, but you kind of get the idea.